Are you looking to optimize SEO of your Shopify store and want to reduce the monthly PPC budget? Obviously, it's hard to get sales without spending on PPC or without actually working on SEO. But SEO is hard. You have to understand how the Google's algorithm works, how the meta title, meta description work, how to basically analyze your page and optimize the blog post and regularly do all of the keyword research and blog posting. What if I say you can automate all of that process with an app in the Shopify and you don't have to hire a dedicated SEO person and you can do that with like 10th of the cost as compared to hiring a dedicated SEO specialist? The app I am talking about is SEO Earn, which can basically automate your SEO process for your Shopify store and reduce your PPC budget because there is a lot of competition out there. And draining your budget on PPC is risky, but you can reduce that risk by focusing a little bit on SEO, which you can do this with SEO, and you don't need to learn how the meta title, meta description, and how basically it works. It's gonna handle everything on its own. It's gonna give you a dashboard through which you can optimize your Shopify store. And I'm gonna walk you through step by step on how you can do that for your store in this video. So if you want to learn, make sure to watch the complete video and try to understand how you can improve your Shopify store's SEO. So without further ado, let's get into the screen where I'm going to show you guys how you can set up this app and improve SEO of your store. So guys, this is the app by Channel Will, SEO Ant. And you can see the features available in the app. It is going to automatically scan your store, prepare an SEO audit checklist, improve your SEO score. It can also optimize the images, as you can see on this screenshot here. And it is going to do keyword research, which might be taking a lot of time of yours, and give you a really cool analysis of which keyword you should be focusing on and how you should write the blog post. Not actually tell you what blog post to write. It's gonna use the AI tool to write the blog post for you as well. So all of these features is available in this app, and there's also a free tier available, so you can use it for free. And if you want to move to the paid plan, you can go on to the paid plan with the 7-day free trial, and you will get the coupon code in the end of this video where you will get 50% off if you use that coupon because you are the visitor of this channel, right? So I'm gonna tell you that how to redeem that coupon for the 50% off. So if $29.99 a month package you want for $15 a month, you can get that if you add that code, and I'm going to show you how you can basically get that discount, right? So guys, let's install the app and show you guys how you can basically do the audit and all of the stuff with this app. I've already installed it on my development store, and that is the dashboard. All you have to do is just click the install button here and you'll be able to install this app and avail the free trial. Obviously, there's a free tier as well. So if you want to use it completely for free, you can just go with the free plan and then move on to the paid tier when you think that it's giving you enough value, right? And this is how it looks. So that is the dashboard of the app. It's giving you all of the stuff which you might need to improve your SEO. It's giving you a complete checklist here. It's giving you a speed score, which is also a really important feature and really important point to improve that search engine optimization. And if you click on view checklist, you can see that it's giving you a score and telling you that how many issues you have which you need to fix. If you scroll down, you can see that 9 is a critical issue, 40 crawl pages. So I have 40 pages on my store and there are some good results as well. So on each point, you can basically click on that and click on fix all now, or click on to optimize. If I click on fix all now, it's gonna do the image compression. That point was for image optimization. So all I have to do is just click on save and fix. Now imagine if you would require it to do manually, you will need to go to every single image and then download it, optimize it, re-upload it again, which is really manual process and really time consuming. But this app can automate that all of the process with just one click of a button. All you have to do is just click it and it is going to optimize the images, not just the size of the image, but it is also going to add image alt text, which you can see. So alt text is basically a label which you add on your image, which help search engine to understand what this image is about. So it basically gets indexed in Google, Bing, and all of the search engine, and your website shows up on the image search as well. So there's one which is the text search, and one is image search, and the other is video search. Adding alt text on images will help you improve SEO of your image, which shows up on top when someone's searching for those specific image. Here you can see that it added the alt text, which was missing, and optimized 89 images with just click of a button, right? And if I close this, it's gonna refresh the score and improve the score. So it still says your score is medium. And if I scroll down, I see some other issues as well. So here we have this speed optimization, which I already did. Still one image showing up. So I've got to click on fix all now. Here we have this content optimization thing, which it's saying that missing H1. So H1 is the first heading which all of the search engine reads to understand what the topic is about, what the page is about, what the product page is about. So here it's saying that collection page is missing H1 headings. There are two collections which is missing H1 heading. Content optimization, here it says homepage is also missing H1 tag. So it's fairly important to add H1 tag if you want your page to be understandable with all of the search engines, right? Here it's saying the content optimization thing. So it is saying to fix the product page, collection page, and the other pages. So all I have to do is just click on fix now and watch it happening automatically. I don't have to manually go into the pages, add an H1 tag and all of that kind of stuff. It's gonna handle all of that on its own. So that's pretty cool. And there's a separate tab for speed optimization. So you can see what other features which can help you improve the score. Here it is on a development store, so it might not give you the accurate because I'm testing that on a development store, but you can check out the detailed report when you click on this detailed report button here, and it will give you a detailed analysis of how you should improve your store. So again, it is currently on a development mode, so it's not going to show up any improvement because it's password protected, but it's going to show up on your store if you will run that on the live store, and it's giving you all of these stuff to improve the site speed up, image optimization, AMP, all that kind of stuff, right? So you don't have to understand any of the technical jargon. You can basically add in the app and implement that. Here we have this content optimization. Now, if I click on that, I have these blog post section. You can see that it's giving you that you need to improve the SEO score for this blog post, which I have. These three blog posts which I have need improvement because the SEO score is pretty low. And the similar score, it's going to show up on the products as well. So if I click on products, you can see that we have this SEO score showing up. Now all I have to do is just click on check SEO details and optimize this button here, and it's gonna improve that stuff. Same for the collection page, home page, and if you just add in any of the keyword. So if I go back to blog post, you can see that we have AI block generator. So you don't have to go into a separate ChatGPT or any other tool. It is going to basically analyze your store and suggest you content based on your store. Now, if I add in t-shirt, round neck t-shirt, right, and click on generate block, it is going to do that for me. Click on next. And here we will need to add in some related keywords, automatically giving you the related keywords. I'm just going to select few of the keywords, and you have this option of selecting the tone of voice. You can give your explicit instructions of how you want this AI blog post generator to work, and all you have to do is just click on generate your blog. Okay, our AI powered blog post is ready, and you can see the score. The previous blog post which I had have low score, but this one got 95, and you can still improve and add in your own input. You might want to add in your own product images. You might want to add in the link of the products which you have in your store. So you can do all of that improvement and just click on publish. There you go. You have your blog post published. now. This is the button to go to that specific Shopify blog. And there you go. Let's click on view to view it on the front end. So that's how our blog post looks. Again, you will have to add in some links and the product images which you are selling. But other than that, you have it pretty much ready, completely SEO optimized. So you don't have to worry about H1, H2, H3, P, all of that kind of tags, right? Okay, let's move on to some other important stuff. So we went over this blog post generation, and the other important aspect is keyword research. Now, whenever you start the SEO process, the first step is to work with keyword research. So you should be focusing on the keyword which are less in competition, but high in volume and relevant to your niche where you're working with, right? So here you can basically add in a keyword and it is going to create a plan for you. So let's test it out. I'm gonna add in keyword like round neck t-shirt to see what's the competition and how it's going to help me achieve that. So let's hit enter. Click on generate. You can see that it's also giving the suggestion that the competition is very high, the volume is this, and if I click on generate, let's see what are the tips and tricks it's going to give me to help me rank the keyword. So guys, our keyword analysis is ready, and here you can see that it's a cluster topic. So there's a term, cluster topic in SEO, where you create a main topic and then create multiple subtopics to basically link to that main topic. So it's giving you that cluster topic where you can try to rank this keyword. So if I zoom in here, you can see that, oops. So here it is. So if I zoom in here, you can see that that should be my main topic, round neck t-shirt for men. That is the average keyword difficulty, which is 97, which is very high in competition. That's the total search volume, and that's the keyword count which we should be focusing on. And these are some subtopics which it created: black round neck t-shirt, over says round neck t-shirt. So I just gave it the keyword round neck t-shirt, and now it's giving me the one cluster topic, which is the main pillar, and then these subtopics, which is going to link to that main pillar topic, right? So that's how we need to work on the SEO optimization thing. And these are the keyword suggestion and recommendation. All of these keywords are really difficult to rank. So keyword difficulty is very high. Obviously, there's a lot of PPC competition. You will need to run some other keywords to find out the keywords which you can target. Here's another topic which it gave, which is crew neck t-shirt. So if I hover over or click here, you can see that is the keyword difficulty, that is total search volume, and that is the keyword count showing up below as well for this topic cluster. So that is our pillar page, and we will have some sub pages as well. So that is our sub page, right? So all of this keyword research and analysis will be visible to you in a very graphical and attractive UI level space, where you can basically think through that which keyword you want to focus on. That, and that is really important to work. Because if you are working on the keyword, just like I am working on this keyword, which is really high in competition, I know that how hard I'll need to add in the efforts to rank those keywords. So my suggestion is to go with the keywords which is medium to low in competition and high in search volume. It's a little difficult to find, but this tool can help you find those keywords really easily. Now, last but not the least, I'm going to tell you how you can get 50% discount on this app. Now, click on this view more. And if you go to pricing for this app, you will click on have a promo code, and you will need to add in WebSense Pro as your promo code to get the 50% off. So make sure to get the 50% off, improve the SEO of your Shopify store, and try to rank and sell more. That's it for this video. Until next video, have a great day.